MadDog Killer Son, you know what I'm saying? We're expanding our channel to include exclusive interviews.
They don't care about the behind the scenes people that are keeping you guys
right.
going and stuff like that, but it's definitely dope when, you know, someone like yourself that knows the history, because everybody knows their history. You know, battle rap, you know history, you know who the who's and the what's, but some of the younger ones, man.
Oh, man.
They're losing it, man. That means we came up in an era that was totally different, and it was not as, it wasn't as saturated. You know what I mean? You were able to concentrate on certain battlers. You were able to concentrate on, you know, certain needs.
Right. First, it was like the Smack DVD. That's all I remember. Yeah. And a little bit of battling at the end. There was a bunch of interviews, a bunch of little, you know, freestyles. And then you had the couple battles. And then I remember Grind Time, you know, sort of being on the internet for a few little battles here and there. And then, you know, Smack sort of gravitated to there. That's the way I remembered it.
Well, it wasn't that Grind Time did a few little battles here and there, see. Like, me, Poison Pen, and Pumpkinhead, may he rest in peace.
Yeah, VPH.
Brought the New York battle scene back.
Right.
By using the Grind Time brand to revamp the whole New York scene again. And there was a point where the West Coast dominated in battle rap. And, you know, you had Lush One. That's when T-Rex battled Awkwards.
Right.
That's when Calico battled and Marv One battled. And we had Calico before Smack. We had Aver before Smack. We had pretty much everybody. You know what I mean?
Right, right. And, Lion's Den was real small. Right.
Yeah, when we built up the New York scene, we were able to prove, number one, we brought the New York scene back. It's back. We went from parks, from the parks, we went little venues, and from little venues, we finally were, like, in venues, like, public assembly, when before it became, you know, Black Bear or whatever. And we did Rich Dollars versus DNA, right?
Mm-hmm.
And that was, like, rectal holds in public assembly. I forgot what year that was. And after that is when we kind of figured out that Smack would probably make a return. And that's exactly what happened the following year. He made the return, and in the beginning, it was just in New York. It was just either Grind Time, East Coast, or New York, which was us, and Smack.
Right.
So you were going to go to either or do both. When these, it's funny because me and Beasley, who was Smack's partner, to this day, were like, don't you miss it when it was just us?
Yeah, it was simple.
But there was more of a control where you could actually, you know, now it's just, I mean, don't get me wrong, it's beautiful. The fact that we've been this huge, battle rap's never been this huge, ever.
I do feel it's a little saturated, and I do feel that, oversaturated, and I do feel as though there's so many leagues, like they don't have an identity. You know, like Grind Time had an identity, their fans had it, you know what I mean? Like, it was like a little bit of a fun, jokey, you know, not to me, Grind Time wasn't as gun heavy, you know, the pistol, smoky, but Smack.
Yeah, we only had like a few guns. Well, we didn't have a few. We had a handful of gun heavy bar
people,
but most of them were just trying to, you know, the well-rounded ones, the ones that can give you all styles and then freestyle and then, you know what I mean?
Right. At least the biggest difference for me from the Grind Time, beginning of Smack era to now is I remember when the battles meant something. Like, if you lost, like, nobody wanted to see you for a while. And there's, like, no penalty now for a loss. It's like, you lost, like, oh, I'm booked all the way from now until June. So it doesn't even matter what their record is. And that, to me, is why we're getting, I don't know, I feel as though we're not getting the quality of battles that...
What happened was, Smack came in and kept the promo style where you had no judging or nothing.
Okay.
The promo style. Because what happened was, in Grind Time,
there was
all your battles were judged, and it wasn't until you won at least 5 to 6 battles where you had the opportunity to have a promo battle. With Smack, it was just promo battle. There was no judge, nothing. So they got rid of the judging factor. Once the judging factor wasn't around, that's when everybody was like, oh, yay, we get to do this. But that kind of, and I agree with you, it kind of ruined what we are.
Right.
You know what I mean? And I feel like we're at a point where it's, how do I say this? Because there's no risk involved anymore, because judging was a risk. It's when you lose, you lost.
Right.
We were able to do judging where everybody got their pay. Everybody got paid, and you, even though if you lost the battle, you got paid because you did the battle. You know what I mean?
Right.
But now, that's not the case. These guys would never, ever agree to any judge battle. They won't agree to certain things that they feel like they're above. Mm. And we kind of created those monsters in a way.
Yeah. Obviously, in the fan bases, you know, a guy could get wiped out. He get on his Twitter, he has 40,000 followers. Oh, you killed him. Oh, you said this line. And then they're like, yeah.
Oh, RIP this person. And it's like, they're not dead, stop. Yeah. Like, you know what I mean? But, yeah, it really, a lot of change. And with me, I saw the saturation. I started seeing all these leagues trying to compete with Mac.
Right.
You know, and they're all trying their best. And the point is, you're not supposed to compete with Smack. Yeah, you're supposed to throw good battles, granted, you know, competition is great.
Right.
But you should be concentrating on building your own lane.
Right.
And instead of just a lot of them concentrating on their own lane, they just, and it wasn't really for Smack they had the hatred for as much as they had the hate for Norbs. You know how that goes. Yeah. And a lot of people just had their vendettas. Well, we can be better than Smack. We can do this, we can do that, we can do this, we can do that. And the one thing about me and Penn, once we left Grind Time, we went with Smack. We went with Smack because we were like, hey, New York sticks with New York.
Right.
And that's exactly what, it was funny because Norbs, Smack, and Chico would be like, join the dark side, guys. Better on the dark side. And I was able to have the first female league on URL channel.
Right, so let's talk. Is that the bras and bra straps?
Yeah, what happened with Bars and Broad Trap was that I just turned it into a booking agency because I got tired of spending my own money.
I know it's tough for league owners, man. I don't understand how they make money, man. It just seems like it's a...
Everybody has a job, and then they put their little stash to the side, and then they add the sponsorship money in, and voila, you have a... There you go. That's the magic. Have a job and get sponsorship, and you can have yourself a good job.
Wow, that is just sad, man.
And that's why I told the fans, because the fans think everybody's rich. No, they have regular jobs.
They do.
Everybody has a job. The only ones that probably don't have a job, and it's because every weekend they're getting major purses.
Right.
Charlie Clips. Loader Lux doesn't have to do anything once you get 40 grand twice
right.
in 1 year.
Right.
You have, Moop, well, I don't know what's going on with Moop, but Moop probably gets paid for other stuff.
Right.
Plus, he's trying to charge $1 million to battle now.
He's crazy, but that's another story.
Yeah, well, that's, yeah, because even Lux and me had a conversation about that 40K. If you're Daylight, if you're an A-verb, if you're a disaster, if you're a popular figure that is in demand and every weekend... or every other weekend,
right.
you're battling, that means, Charlie Clips, for instance, he gets up to $10,000.
Right.
If he battles this weekend, $10,000, boom, cash, $10,000 the following weekend. You're able to make a living, especially if you're budgeting yourself correctly and stacking your money, you're going to be able to be fine. These young ones, or these ones that have a little buzz, a little mini buzz, it's not the same thing. Now, league owners, I believe right now Organic, if he's not working, it's because King of the Dot got that far. Same thing with Smack, but I say Smack because Smack is an entity by himself, even without the URL brand. If Smack wanted to branch off and do his own thing, everybody's going to go follow Smack.
Right.
So, you know, he's a different story. So, everybody has a job, you know what I mean? Like, everybody's working. If they're not working... you know, then they're hustling up something and getting, you know, the sponsorship money. Everybody got their jobs. It's just a matter of It's like what our parents used to tell us when we grew up. You know, rap music ain't gonna pay the bills.
Right, right. And it's one of them things that you never expected it to turn into actual lane. I never expected it to turn into a lane where they're actually, the rappers are actually fans of battle rappers. So that's just a total turnaround.
So, yeah, and then you have, like, Drake. Drake is a fan of Thurston. Right. You know, he sponsored the King of the Dot event. He didn't try to make it his own event. He sponsored the event and helped them put the battles together. We need people like a Drake to do something like that. Not like, you know, everybody like Snoop Dogg, and Snoop Dogg said, I want to do my own battle rap event. And it kind of flopped. So a flop for Snoop Dogg is not bad because he's still getting his money.
Right.
Which is different for, like, a flop for Smack. You know what I mean? Like, they flopped, they got backup money, and that little money they made off of just doing this little event. We flop, it's a bad flop. You know what I mean? So what I ended up doing was understanding that it was all saturated, understanding that everybody's just being really money thirsty, trying to be Smack. Smack's just trying to get on TV somehow, in my opinion, at this point, because where else can he go? And it's just going everywhere. And then for about 2 years, I did my research, and me, Lex Banco, C3, and K-Profit at one of the Queen of the Rings.
I love C3. Is that your starting lineup? What's your starting lineup?
No, no. Actually, I'm concentrating on one battle.
Okay.
I'm having tryouts so I can figure out what the roster's going to be. I ain't putting on okey-doke on that. Because gay or not, you still got to have bars.
That's right.
So, you know what I mean? You gotta have bars and presents. So, I have MONTEZ Love and CALI M.
So that's your first two.
Yeah, those two right now, because they've been in the game already. They battled in Trap House, New Jersey, and ironically, a lot of openly gay men came to me from Trap House, New Jersey. But
so, the name of the league is still the same, or is it slightly different?
Tomorrow, the Prism Battle League is the first LGBT. So that's going to be MONTEZ Love versus CALI M. There's open tryouts, so whoever, you know, shows up.
I wish I was down there. I would have made the trip. I would have. The next event, you got to give me some ample notice, and I'll try and make a trip down there. You know, just.
I'm thinking about maybe a month and a half, 2 months. I might
do
another
perfect.
One.
That'll be perfect, because I know that there's going to be a RBE event February 27th.
Oh, you know that's my team, baby. That's Team Homie versus Writer's Block.
Yeah, I'm gonna be there for that, man. So we'll definitely.
Well, then we'll be right there. I'll be right sitting next to you because I will be rooting for my home team. You know how I am.
Yep.
But it's always something. Huh. So it is what it is, though. They just gotta get on their job.
Anything else we need to know before we sort of roll out of here, or you wanna give me a plug?
January 9th.
Okay.
This is a battle league, first LGBT battle league ever in battle rap. Tomorrow, 5 p.m., MONTEZ versus CALI M. And Team Homie, February 27th, Homie versus Right of the Block.
That's
Homie
what's
over
up.
Everything.
That's
what's watch up. That Fire Boy versus T Moneybags. That's out right now for RBE. Shout out to ARP.
That's my man, ARP.
Yeah, man. Shout out to the whole RBE and ARP. And shout out to the East Coast Renaissance Studio. And shout out to Ali on the Man, Angelique, Hurricane Dew. Holy shit. Gio, everybody that's on Prism staff and helping out the situation tomorrow. I want to shout all of them out and just say shout out to all the fans, the ones that love me and hate me.
That's what's up.
Hey, my dude, MadDog. That's known. Now that me and MadDog link, you know that means you're going to see him more, right?
All right. That's what's up. Sara Kana in the building. I respect
you. Already know, MadDog. Good looking, man.
Thank you. And this is the first of many, all right?
This broken wings. Hands are coming. Hear me once again. So let's I can fly.
I was right or wrong, to live my life as an outlaw all along. Remain strong in this planet full of player haters. They conversate with death row full of demonstrators.